Are you tired of seeing those 403 forbidden errors that block you while testing? Don't worry, some effective techniques could help to avoid this hassle. Let's explore some tricks to bypass the 403 status code. This status code is made to limit users' access to specific hosts, endpoints, etc. It could be implemented either in the web application code or there could be certain web application firewall rules. There might be different cases for bypasses because there are different sets of technologies. So it does mean that there won't be all-in-one solution for the most cases, but we are gonna still explore the most common ways. There are multiple techniques what we could try in this video: applying special characters to the URL, switching HTTP methods, headers manipulation, switching IP, or using a VPN provider. I might add some extra techniques in part 2. Subscribe to not miss the upcoming videos. I also have a Patreon where you can get videos in advance, special mentions, access to live hacking recordings, and some other interesting things like recon data. Let's start with a method which is pretty easy to check. If you get 403 status just by trying to access a certain endpoint, while on other endpoints you are getting 200, this could be one of the first things to try. The idea is to check the web application's handling of different HTTP methods like GET, POST, PUT, DELETE, etc. to see if changing them could lead into other status codes like 200. It's just simple as that. Quickly check this. You could use HTTP proxy like BORP, or you can send requests with CLI tools like curl. Another technique could be used when you get 403 code than trying to access website for the first time. I do recommend trying to play around with those headers. Either you could use 127.0.0.1 localhost, or even some cloud internal IPs could work as well. Some Burp Suite plugins actually do that, or you could just inject another header like this inside the request. Also use this with CLI tools as an extra header, for example when using HTTPX at the mass scale. You could also get blocked by web application firewall by doing malicious actions. For example, if you send too many requests containing known malicious payloads, using too many requests per second, trying to access known sensitive files, your IP might get blacklisted. Your IP could get blacklisted for a certain amount of time or even indefinitely. For this reason, I'd recommend having either IP proxy, which could take more effort to set up, or just using VPN provider. I do use NordVPN, not for those bullshit reasons to access certain content, but mainly when I get blocked while testing. I do save a lot of time and nerves when using this product, since others could be slow or not really reliable. And the last one is using some tricks to the URL path. I have had most success with this one. Either if you're having issues accessing the website for the first time or certain endpoint is not reachable, it is worth trying to send these payloads. I have discovered some swagger documentation sites while using this method, which eventually led me to discover more severe bugs like SQL injection. As the introduction of 403 bypasses, we covered some ways to tackle 403 forbidden errors, from simple URL changes to sophisticated header manipulations. In the second part, we will dive into more techniques and I will show you one of my favorite command line utilities to automate detection. It was my pleasure sharing this knowledge and I wish you a nice hunt. And I will give special thanks to these people who made this video possible.